Ooh, that's ugly. Do that again. That looks kind of squishy, guys.
I have like 24 altogether.
Well, why don't you,
Durkin and Son.
Well, then you go out there and spy on those rabble, that rabble out there behind the shed. I mean, I'm glad you all are here protecting us from that, from them. They are something.
I'm glad to see you.
There certainly are, and I have gotten a whole group of them together to make it into the troops.
Nice.
Yes, indeed. Wait, I think it's my patriotic duty as a daughter of the
yeah.
And also like a good Christian woman.
Yeah, I gotta get a shot of some of those.
Fly!
Fly, Robin, fly! Da 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 da! Up into the sky! Crunch, 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 crunch.
I saw some colored fellers do that.
Oh, yeah? C-U-L-A-U-D?
Yeah.
Colored?
Colored.
Oh, that's authentic. The Churchill impression is authentic. Vaguely stoned look there. Do that again. Peace, brother. There's my son.
Man, we got some good herbs this weekend, I.
No!
Come on!
No! Lack sincerity because I said it the first time.
Say it again. Come on. How do you feel about the cicadas, honey?
This is disgusting. It is disgusting. You're going to sleep in that? You're going to eat with that smell? Okay, are you happy now?
Demeanor?
Yes. Your courtly demeanor.
I want you to know that bullet that hit me was by a sniper. I wasn't running away.
So you have been wounded?
Right here.
I just don't know what to say.
Well, it was a trifle.
You know, sir, that bullet could have come from my own son's gun. My son.
Does that make him a son of a gun?
In the thick of the fight, he wouldn't even have known he was hit. This is a strange war, isn't it, Mrs. Wood?
Certainly
is, my dear. And we're met here today, not on a battlefield, but on the grounds of a lovely home for a beautiful wedding, in the middle of our national trouble. And this fine man who I spoke ill of when I first heard of him. I spoke ill of this man. He was a Yankee, of course, but he was my daughter's choice. And my daughter's choice is my choice.
Southerner, the one who believes in union. The destiny of this great nation.
So how can you be a Southerner and believe in the union?
Why, ma'am, General George Thomas is a Southerner and believes in the Union.
He's a brave young man defending the Constitution and the Union of this country.
I just wish that General Robert E. Lee, that symbol of Christian gentlemanship, had recognized the higher calling and commanded our own federal forces.
He almost
this
did.
This cruel war would have been over already.
It will be over soon.
It'll be over soon. Yeah. I know you men are going to take care of us and defend
Sergeant
us.
Sergeant Dawson, have you met our lovely Miss Dora Higgins?
By reputation only.
Well, it's very nice to meet you. I live across the street. And have I seen you down at the store since you've been here?
No, Well, ma'am, military duties have kept me in camp up here.
We have a fine selection of merchandise down in our store.
A locust?
A locust?
I hate those locusts. My goodness, and for my daughter's wedding, I didn't, down in Georgia, we didn't have these creatures.
Do not hate them, ma'am.
They had fire ants.
Divine plan, even they too have a place.
He is a good Christian. I hope that you will come down to the
very good at
the end. My son down there. And we welcome all you fine boys in blue at church. We really do.
Raj, what's in the box?
Cookies.
Let's see, shall we? Who made them, Raj?
My wife, did they? Da-da-da-da-da-da. Get any better on that? Hey, I'm composing for crying out loud. I'm not on the concert stage at the moment.
Alcoholic of the event in general, huh? He's working his way down the tent. Boy, this is exciting footage, let me tell you.
That's
nice. Do that again.
We need to get a roll of little fun time with everybody because right now the guard
That's bound to be a popular statement.
That's West. I had a bad habit of posting guards and forgetting them.
I knew it.
I thought you were going to say Fort McHenry. I was going to say Washington. I wasn't. But.
Yeah.
Depth to the cicadas. Full speed ahead.
Yeah. Arr. Don't fire until you see the orange of their eyes. Is that it?
Arr.
Yes. The pirate vowel, sir?
A-E-I-O-R.
Very good. Thank you. Let's see. You got the shoulders. You don't have the stripes on yet.
Not yet.
Okay. Someday, perhaps.
You had a wicked?
Picture
some ketchup, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Not on my
mouth. Like hide! Hide! It's the wicked Yankee cameraman.
Can't have the store. No, you can't have it. It's my brother's.
Gee, this is neat. Track the... All right, there was a...
Where have you been? Like an old park movie. Where have you been?
I've been out drinking.
Drinking again?
Again.
How many times have I told you not to go out drinking?
All my pay.
What are we going to do with you, Mike?
Gone.
I was going to kiss him, but I can't.
Oh, go ahead.
No, you
come on, go ahead.
No, you
go, I dare you.
The temperance pledge.
No, I haven't.
Well, shame on you, sir.
You see, I'm a papist. We drink wine. Do you know,
oh, you're one of them Irish devils, are you?
I am the...
The signing of the marriage.
Wait till after I have the name off the board.
Here comes Mama.
Okay, you guys are almost busy. You're almost my camera.
Okay.
It looks like she just had something that tastes sour. Oh, good. The guy with the t-shirt. He's real foraging.
Mary.
Yeah, it's nice. Just. Yeah, stay right there. Don't move. Put the hat on, will you? That's nice, huh? Walks right into my shot.
What he said. She what?
She looks nervous.
If you were getting married to Don Terry, wouldn't
like
you look
crying about it? And
the thing is, I think they're fooling Don Terry. So bring from state to can build it up. Mr. Ad Libo.
You can get married with
him. You give Roger Frank, weren't you closer to 40 years? My humor. I have no idea where that is.
What's your opinion of this marriage, Sergeant Dierken?
Well, like most wartime marriages, I don't have a very high opinion of it.
I see. See, that's a nice shot. The bride all in white. On the arm of her father with cicadas flying by.
West.
Rod, why don't you get down there?
I'll get down there.
No, actually.
West. We should reenact a mafia when he busts all the cameras.
Actually, the bride's mother.
Hey, you. Oh, nice film.
Yeah, do a mafia wedding.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, here we go. You know how to use one of these? You know how to use one. I'm supposed to be involved in
it. And in the face of this company, to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony. A state which is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, and therefore is not by any be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, soberly, and in the fear of God.
Hold on a second! She gave herself to me spiritually and physically!
You stubborn child! I do require, in charging those here in the presence of God and within this congregation here gathered, that if you know any reason by which you may not lawfully be wed, you hear now in the presence of God state it.
What exactly would that mean?
Let us proceed. James, wilt you have this woman to thy wedded wife to live together after God's ordinance, the holiest state of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health? And forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her as long as ye both shall live. Carolyn, wilt thou have this man to thy wedded husband, to live together under God's ordinance, the holiest state of matrimony? Wilt thou obey him, to serve him, love, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health? And forsake making all others. Keep thee only unto him as long as he boasts thou live.
I will.
Who giveth this woman to marry us this man?
I do.
I, James, take thee, Caroline, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to care, according to God's holy ordinance, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I plight thee to my trust, and thereto. I, Caroline, take thee, James.
Take thee, James.
To obey till death us do part.
To obey till death us do part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto I give thee my son.
And thereto I give thee.
May I have the ring. Bless, O Lord, this ring, that she who wears it may in obedience and in loving kindness enjoy that which has been given to her, and may he who gives it enjoy and love that which has been given to him. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. O eternal God, creator and preserver of all mankind, giver of all spiritual gifts, the author of everlasting life, send thy blessing upon these thy servants, this man and this woman, whom we bless in thy name, that as Isaac and Rebekah lived faithfully together, so these persons may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant betwixt them made, whereof this ring given and received is a token and pledge, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to thy laws through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put asunder, for as much as James and Carolyn have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God and this company, and thereto have given and pledged their troth, each to the other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving a ring, and by joining hands, I pronounce that they are man and wife, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with his favor look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that ye may so live together in this life, that in the world to come ye may have life everlasting. Amen.
Who's going to kiss the bride? I didn't get to kiss the bride? I've been ripped off. Into their home of wedded connubial bliss. I wonder if that poor girl knows what she's into. Of course, we know him a lot better than anybody else does, being our sergeant.
I'm
gonna get a shot of that can there. That's what now? Strobe light, okay? Tell me, ma'am, what do you think are some of the advantages of, say, a light beer over a premium malt?
It tastes great and it's less filling.
I see, thank you. It was brought to you by National Bow, the official beer of the 3rd Maryland Volunteers.
Oh, man, I'll show you what a haversack's made for, dude.
National Beer, we're here to sing about National Beer, and while we're singing, we're proud to say it's brewed on the shores of the Chesapeake Bay. Catch!
Huzzah! Huzzah! That woman puts more beer away than I could spill.
My first one!
I couldn't drink half the beer that woman.
Oh, there's a suicidal one over there. Home in on her. What are you reading? Suicide. Oh, okay.
The ones that are fighting?
Yeah, the one that just leaned over to pick something up. Probably a cicada. No breakfast.
Check. Turn to your right.
I'll duck.
Classic. Look at the kid in the bag.
The quo vadis.
So they're going to snuff the bald guy or what?
Yeah.
That's going to sound good in the film. They're going to snuff the bald guy?
What is that even step that's being
done?
like G. Walker is if.
And inhumane. Oh, these guys are bloodthirsty.
There goes 20% of the fighting for
us. It's like some other guy fired too early. End up executing. I want to see this guy fly.
Stick around and see if he comes alive.
I think it was the same thing.
Did the guy even get his own blindfold? He's got to get one with blood and brain matter all over.
Yeah.
I'd hate to have them slapping that thing around my face.
For cruelly executing
them. They were brothers.
Oh, play down 6-0.
That's Confederate for you. Have fun.
I love it. Hey, we have fun.
Private Duggan of the due process of law.
What, you want to be blown apart? Shot one?
Hey, keep misfiring, we won't need to have a battle tomorrow.
Firing party, shoulder, arm. Ready!
Steady, man, steady.
Aim! Fire! Shoulder! Arm!
I didn't know you fall straight backwards.
Kill the guys that miss.
You have to shoot them again. That's a lot of
kill the guys that miss for
two dummies pull them off.
Disobeying an order. There's Hugh up there.
Okay, I want 4 men to kill. This Private Duggan is out. You take him back to the
what was that?
Is there something else better to shoot? Why is your light blinking?
That means you're on.
Oh, I thought I meant the battery was down. Well, is there something else better to shoot right now?
I'm shooting it.
Well, I got to get dressed in my civilian stuff for that induction ceremony at 7. But right now, I guess for the next hour, I can play around, I guess. I wish I could shoot something and be in it at the same time.
Jumping jack flash, get your gas, gas, gas.
Got daddy in bed, a dog.
Mud stain.
Now, wait a minute, you're in my room. Da 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 da
da da da. Wait a minute. All right. Yeah. Woo!
Stout.
Would you all like to take the oath to the Union right now?
Yeah, here.
Repeat after me and raise your right hand. I, your name.
I, Harvey.
Born in the state of?
Born in the state of Maryland.
Age? 29. Voluntarily enlist this 6th day of 1862. As a soldier in the Army of the United States of America.
Soldier in the United States of America.
For the period of 3 years.
3 years?
Unless sooner discharged by proper authority.
It'll be over in 6 months. Don't worry about it, lads.
That's right. You also agree to accept such bounty. Pay rations and clothing.
Pay rations and clothing.
As are or may be established by law.
As are or may be established by law.
And I,
you
may,
and I
do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
That I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the United States of America.
To the United States of America.
And I will serve them honestly and faithfully.
And I will serve them honestly and faithfully.
Against all their enemies.
Against all their enemies.
Or opposers whomsoever.
And opposers whomsoever.
That I will observe and obey.
And I will observe and obey.
The orders of the President of the United States.
The orders of the President of the United States.
And the orders of the officers appointed over me. According to the rules and articles of war.
According to the rules and articles of war.
Congratulations, gentlemen. These five stout young men are going forth to do battle in your cause, to defend your homes against those who would take your government away from you. Look at these men. These men here in blue. Each one of them made the sacrifice to join the army to defend your rights. Matt, here, please. You. Please, Matt, here, please. Here. Are there any of you you will not defend her honor and not defend the rights of the United States of America. You will not fight for the enemy. Can any of you face her? Are there any other men out here? Are the rest of you successions? Because if you are, we got a place for you too. 6 feet under.
Yeah.
Three cheers for the Union.
Hip, hip, hip.